Most of us can recall going to the supermarket and seeing a bag of Flamin' Hot Cheetos on the shelf. But many people may be unaware of how the entrepreneur behind the hot cheese-flavored snack brand came up with the idea and achieved success. Richard Montanez used to pick grapes with his family while growing up in a migrant farm laborers camp in Southern California during the 1960s. He was one of 10 children born to Mexican immigrants. But his life completely changed after working for the snack giant. It was an early morning in the late 1980s. Executives at Frito-Lay, including the CEO, CMO, and a team of VPs, had gathered in a conference room to attend a presentation by Richard Montanez. Richard was nervous as he was a nobody standing in front of high-level executives. He was not a businessman. He didn't even know the basics of running a business, as he was a high school dropout. In fact, Montanez was a janitor at Frito-Lay. But he was a janitor with an idea. It was his idea that was going to make the company billions of dollars. His recipe of snacks was going to become one of the most iconic foods, Flamin' Hot Cheetos. In 1976, a neighbor told him about a job opening up in Rancho Cucamonga. The Frito-Lay plant was looking for a janitor. He met with the hiring manager and got the job as he'd been working since he had dropped out of high school. In between shifts, he went out to learn as much as he could about the company's products. He spent time in the warehouse and watched the machines churn out crunchy snacks. Eventually, his insatiable curiosity paid off. By the mid-1980s, the company that he had worked for had fallen on tough times. As a way to boost morale, then-CEO Roger Enrico recorded a video message. Enrico encouraged every worker at the company to act like an owner. Most employees did not pay heed to it, but Montanez took it to heart. One day, Montanez asked of the company's salesman to tag along and learn about the process. He agreed and took Montanez to a convenience store in a Latino neighborhood with him. While the salesman restocked inventory, Montanez made an accidental observation. He saw the products of his company on the shelves and found them all to be very plain compared to the chips stocked at the next rack of Mexican spices. He realized that Frito-Lay had no spicy or hot products. A few weeks later, Montanez stopped at a local vendor to get Mexican street corn, and it was covered in chili powder, salt, and lime juice. Montanez then got an idea to put chili on Cheetos. Working late one night at the production factory, he took some Cheetos that had not yet been sprinkled in cheese. He took them home and, with the help of his wife, covered them in his mixture of chili powder and some spices. He handed them out to his family members and friends. They all liked the snacks very much. Montanez's confidence increased after getting positive comments from his peers. He was ready to take his invention to higher authorities. He earned his CEO's number and told him that he had heeded his call to action and he had crafted his snacks in his kitchen. Enrico loved his ingenuity. He told the janitor that he'd be at the plant in 2 weeks and asked him to prepare a presentation. Moments after, Montanez hung up the phone and the plant manager stormed up to him. He scolded him for calling the CEO directly. After he had let all his anger out, he finally asked him to prepare for his presentation. Montanez was 26 years old. He could not read or write very well, let alone knew how to formulate a business proposal. But he wasn't about to give up. Along with his wife, he went to the library, found a book on marketing strategies, and copied the first 5 paragraphs. He filled about 100 plastic baggies with his homemade treats at home, sealed them with a clothing iron, and manually drew a logo and design on each package. Montanez bought a black tie with blue and red stripes for $3 for his presentation and had his neighbor knot it for him. I know it has been an interesting story so far, but I assure you it gets way more interesting than this. Make sure to stick until the end so you are up to date with the latest scandal regarding Montanez and the Flamin' Hot Empire. Now, let's get back to the story. Montanez went and presented his idea the best way he could. During the presentation, an executive in the room interjected him and asked him how much market share he thought he could get. Montanez had no idea what he was talking about. He did not even know how he was going to respond to his question. Instinctively, he opened his arms and told him this much market share. The room went silent as the CEO stood up and smiled. He had liked Montanez's snacks and his idea. He shared his views with other people in the room, then turned to Montanez and told him that he would have to leave his cleaning job to work with them. 6 months later, with Montanez's help, Frito-Lay began testing Flamin' Hot Cheetos in small Latino markets in East Los Angeles. Montanez knew that the company would move forward with the product only if the product sold well, and if it didn't, they would scratch it. Montanez knew that their people wanted his creation to fail, but he wouldn't let it happen. Montanez came up with another plan. He assembled a small team of family members and friends, went to the test markets, and bought every bag of Cheetos he could find. He would also comment, telling the shopkeepers that those snacks were great. In 1992, Flamin' Hot Cheetos received a green light for a nationwide release. In a short time, the snack became one of Frito-Lay's history's most successful product launches. Today, Flamin' Hot Cheetos is one of Frito-Lay's hottest-selling commodities. it has become a billion-dollar snack that is enjoyed by everyone from Katy Perry to middle school students. The success of Montanez's snack is so huge that there is even a rap song about them. Over 35 years of his career, the former janitor has risen through the corporate ranks and is now the vice president of multicultural sales of PepsiCo America. The company is the holding company of Frito-Lay. Before Montanez joined the executive team, Frito-Lay had only 3 Cheeto products. Since then, the company has launched more than 20. Each of those products is worth more than $300 million. Recognized as one of the most influential Hispanic leaders in America, Montanez is a gifted speaker who often tours the country, giving keynotes. Soon, his story is going to hit the silver screen. Fox Searchlight Pictures is currently working on a biopic about his life titled Flamin' Hot. Montanez still lives in Rancho Cucamonga, giving back to his community and teaching MBA classes at a nearby college. Recently, a student asked him how he was teaching without a PhD, to which he responded that he did have a PhD. He has been lacking, hungry, but determined. Although this is a story that has lately been questioned and thoroughly investigated by the Los Angeles Times for being a complete lie, it is truly an inspiring rags-to-riches story. The fact that Montanez was the actual creator of the Flamin' Hot brand is a complete mystery. And since the wave of accusations he has received for his story, he stands firm, saying that no one is going to take this away from him. In the end, the executives of Frito-Lay didn't confirm or deny this story. But what is real is that he climbed the corporate ladder like few people have been able to. That's the end of our video. Do you think Richard Montanez's story is real or not? Comment right below what you think about him and his story. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any more videos of The Millionaire Post. We'll see you in the following video. Take care.